Today, we'll be looking into the lore of Arataki Itto.
Arataki numero uno Itto here in the flesh.
Itto, the Oni, who is the leader of the Arataki Gang. The name Arataki means to lead in the Maori language, and Itto is a Japanese name meaning one, though other translations state that Arataki means rough rapids in Japanese. The Arataki art is one of the four famous martial arts schools in Inazuma, with its founder likely being Itto's ancestor, known as Arataki of the Front Gate. Despite being referred to as an Oni, he is only half Oni, as integrating with humans caused the Oni bloodline to thin out over time. We can see this gradually happening in the past with Chiyo, who had pale skin on her face, but seems to have the original red colour on her arms and legs. Itto's constellation, Taurus Iracundus, is Latin for Raging Bull. This may be a reference to the Buddhist deity known as Gozu Tenno, the ox-headed heavenly king, who was associated with the god of storms, Susanoo, which would mean he was a pretty wild but heroic figure, quite fitting for Itto. Another ancestor of his could be the infamous Otogi Kongo Lion King, as Ito's burst is said to release his inner Oni King. He was alive during the Cataclysm, as we see him lose a sumo match against Chiyo, who is described as a petite Oni in the Redhorn Stone Thresher description. After this, he senses the Dark Army approaching, telling her and the children in the area to follow the Fox Envoy and hide while he dealt with the creatures from beyond the ocean. Promising to swing by later and have a few wrestling bouts with Chiyo when he was done. However, his fate is unknown, as he has not been seen since. Itto is well known for his high spirits and loud personality. Many of the people see him as a nuisance, none more so than Kujo Sara, especially after she confiscated his vision.
I can't help but get a little irate when his name comes up. He kicked up a big fuss when I confiscated his vision. By far the noisiest person. Now, the noisiest Oni I've ever encountered. He showed he was enough of a man to admit defeat, but the rematch he insisted upon... To this day, I still don't want to talk about it. If you really must know, you can go and ask him yourself.
It's just a sumo street fight. I mean, what's she so afraid of? If she keeps snubbing me, I'm gonna have to stop calling her Kujo Tengu and start calling her Kujo Chicken. We'll see what she thinks of that.
Though he generally has a positive attitude, Itto's past was one of exclusion and rejection due to his Oni heritage. When he was a child, he was told the story of the Crimson Oni and the Blue Oni. The Crimson Oni was gentle and helpful, while the Blue Oni was wicked and cruel towards humans. The gentle Crimson Oni then defeated the wicked Blue Oni and won the respect of the humans. This was Itto's favorite story and made him proud of his red horns, though he would later discover that in reality, the Blue Oni chose to avoid humans while giving the Crimson Oni an easier path to integrating with human society through their made-up tale. Unfortunately, the pride young Itto had in his heritage would be shaken due to his family being blamed for any incidents of robbery that occurred in their village. This eventually led to his family being driven out of their home. As they were leaving, Itto could not understand the disgusted stares of his neighbors and would hear a phrase that he would continue to hear to this day. Once an Oni, always an Oni. The humans in the village did not care for the tales of the gentle Crimson Oni, and saw all Oni the same way, This caused Itto to question whether it would be better to act as the blue Oni that people feared, as he would be treated that way no matter what. After being driven out of their village, Itto's parents both died of illness, leaving him out on the streets to take care of himself. Any time he would hear people speak ill of his race, he would fight them, though with him only being a child, and on his own, it usually wound up with him getting beaten up. Still, his tenacity was fierce, and he'd always stand back up no matter how many times he was knocked down. He was a tough kid, but he was still only a kid. He collapsed in the street due to exhaustion, having not eaten for days, and being beaten up by a gang that had teamed up against him. Nobody paid attention to him, except an old human woman who offered him some porridge to eat. Itto couldn't understand the kindness that he'd never received before from a human, and pointed out to her that he was an Oni multiple times. She didn't care though, and persuaded him to eat some of the porridge she'd made, eventually taking him in and raising him herself. This earned her the nickname Granny Oni.
Granny Oni isn't an Oni at all. In fact, she's the kindest human that has ever lived. She only got her nickname because she took me in. If people have got a problem with me, fine. I don't care what other people think anyway. But I wish people wouldn't go after her because of me.
This feeling of acceptance from Granny Oni inspired Itto to become the protector of anyone he saw as an outcast, as he knew exactly what it felt like. This eventually turned into the infamous Arataki Gang, who he views as family, though the date of it becoming official is debated by pretty much everyone in the gang. Itto is undoubtedly the leader of the gang, but he is often challenged by Kuki Shinobu, his second in command.
Nobody questions my leadership in the gang. What I say goes. Except when it comes to Shinobu. She's always challenging everything I say. And not only that, all the hard-earned loot I bring back and share with everyone, she goes and returns it. But also, she gets me out of jail and out of every mess we get ourselves into, so I'll let it slide. Besides, I don't want to get on her bad side. An angry Shinobu would make my life a nightmare.
The hard-earned loot Itto refers to is usually won through competitions with kids, something he seems to do to make the kids' lives happier, to some degree. But his competitive spirit means that he puts all of his effort into winning, never seeming to throw games, even though he loses a lot. This is often seen as irresponsible by the adults, but the kids all seem to enjoy having him as a playmate, and the games he introduces them to, such as Oni Kabuto battles, are a favorite, as they're easier to win against Itto. Though Itto does sometimes get a bit jealous when the kids turn their attention to Yoimiya.
She's always showing off her fancy fireworks and toys to the kids. Well, I'm sick of it! Nobody steals my thunder! I'm the one who's supposed to be adored by the kids. Me!
His need to be number one also manifests in other strange ways, such as hearing about Toma's vision being taken.
Some of the boys have been telling me that he was the star of the show at the Vision Hunt ceremony. I'm like, are you kidding me? How come he gets his own special ceremony? Was the 100th vision supposed to be, like, stronger than the other 99 or something? Nah, that can't have been it, because, hello, they would have chosen me if that's what they were going for.
And his battle with the Aimiko. One day, just as he'd been paid, he was feeling hungry, so he went to his favorite food stand, only to find that a fox-eared lady was sitting in the chair he always sat in. Instead of taking another seat, the two argued over who the chair belonged to, which resulted in an unnecessary battle. Itto chose for it to be an eating contest, and Yai chose the theme to be Kitsune Ramen. This particular dish contained fried tofu, which was made from beans, something that all Oni are allergic to, Itto especially. Regardless, his pride was on the line, so he ate 32 bowls of it and defeated her through sheer determination, something less than a handful could say when dealing with Yai, though his victory had its downsides.
I crushed that kitsune ramen eating contest we had. Even all that fried tofu couldn't stand in my way. She didn't come close to beating me. I was bedridden for more than a month after that. But you know what? I'd rather lie in bed a winner than walk away a loser. So, anyway, I had the last laugh because she had to foot the bill for 32 bowls of noodles. Ha ha!
The two contests that weigh on his mind the heaviest are to do with Tengu. One is the rematch with Kujo Sara in the form of a street sumo match, and the second was when he was young. He had gotten into an argument with a young Tengu, and their sumo match resulted in them both rolling down a mountain in Byakko Plain. Itto sprained his ankle, and the young Tengu carried him all the way home, with the match remaining unsettled. This young Tengu has not been named yet, but I have a suspicion it may have been Sara. She lived in the mountains and was thought to be a boy by many when she was a child. The parallels between the two would be a nice touch too, both being taken in by humans as children, but still feeling somewhat like outsiders due to being different. Itto is also a big fan of Miss Hina. He writes in to the That's Life magazine for advice from her, saying,
"If you ever have something on your mind, you can always try writing in to That's Life magazine's advice column. Miss Hina always manages to come up with an encouraging and heartwarming response for all her readers. Just look at me. I used to be a lost soul, but not anymore. And it's all thanks to her. That reminds me. I managed to sign up for one of her upcoming meet and greets. Oh, I've been counting down the days. Wish it would go faster."
Though Itto doesn't realize that the one actually giving him advice is Gorou, with Miss Hina being a creation of Yai's to boost the magazine's sales. Itto does have some inclination, though, as he says this about Gorou.
"Oh yeah, the doggy general in the resistance. Hey, I've got to hand it to him. He may be on the small side, but he's got quite the fighting spirit. Also, he gives off this vibe that makes me feel all warm and fuzzy inside. Almost as if he understands my innermost feelings. I mean, I barely met the guy, so it's kind of weird."
And another of his favorite people is Kamisato Ayato, who he views as a sort of big brother, due to Ayato encouraging him to carry on after his 780th beetle fighting loss. This caused Itto to believe that the two of them were on the same wavelength and have a mutual respect for each other, though Ayato's thoughts on Itto are still a mystery. So, Itto may not be the sharpest horn on the Oni, but Granny Oni knows what a big heart he has and has witnessed his selfless attitude towards those he views as misunderstood or in need of help. She sums it up quite well.
"Oh yes, and you know what? I think that's what makes him adorable. Wouldn't you agree? He does whatever he puts his mind to. He's sincere, brave, and determined. Back when I took him in, everyone thought I was most unusual indeed. They started calling me Granny Oni. But I've never been ashamed of this name. On the contrary, I'm quite proud of it. Because Itto is my pride and joy."
And that's all I've got on Itto. He's quickly become one of my favorite characters, and I hope we get to see a lot more of him in the future. Thank you for watching, good luck on your wishes, and I hope you have a great day.